And in this area, whenever you study about anything, it will create some sort of natural utility in the society. Anything that creates a natural utility in society, how industry develops, how technology develops, everything starts from utility. If you understand about a concept, comprehension of a concept or comprehension of a base of a concept, even though automation has not come, mobility or transport was conceived earlier. Transportation was conceived earlier, then wheel was also a supplementary tool for that, then gradually this automation or automobile industry that came into existence. So at least a partial, selective, fragmental view of the usage of any commodity, that is the starting spirit or the starting spark of any development. So first is the comprehension of a partial or selective view of a component or compound that has resulted in creating own utility. Utility has increased the need. Need will increase the application. This application, need and utility will increase demand in the society. Demand urges the person to go for more innovation. This innovation boosts the creativity to result in technical implications. This is how all industries develop. So now it is also recyclable. Demand increases technology. Technology creates more utility. More utility increases more demand. So for studying the multimedias, future and fortune, we have to understand this food cycle, just as the food cycle for normal consumption is manifested in biology and various other schools of study. Utility and productivity in the society, emerging society, existing society and expected society in the future, that is created in the formula by which we have to go through. One is utility, then need, then application, they create demand. Demand urges the person to go for creative tools and innovative temper and innovative boosting. This is the proper way of study. And what is the use of this multimedia industry, where it is applied? If we cannot understand that thing, we cannot create new opportunities for we people. So, four things. You have to create the fortune, I have already told. You have to create a future, I have already told. By which we have to create a base for two things. One is, by understanding the foundation principles of multimedia, you have to create new designs, and new designs should create new opportunities in the society. But if 1,000 people are going to the multimedia services or multimedia mere studies, only one or two people are going to deal with the foundations of multimedia. If you understand the foundation of multimedia and compare it to the need of the society, where it can be applied. For example, I am just visualizing just my car's way. There are a lot of auto security softwares are available, and multimedia projections and virtual reality, as well as model simulation structures are available in collision test, construction test, designing test, boosting and comparative advancement test in model making in automobiles, and even ship makings and aircraft makings. We are seeing a lot of other benefits. Likewise, there is a model which is available for this auto security, whereby the car, it clearly makes the person to envision where is the round clearance, where is the ground clearance, where is the arbitrary clearance, where is the angle of rotation, angle of deviation, then sensing the proximity of any other vehicle coming now and boosting the sound signals that are processed which may not be heard by a closed air-conditioned car, and lot of other various things pertaining to the security of the vehicle as well as the indwellers and travelers that have been pondered by various people, and that is in the form of the software. The same thing by means of this virtual reality and modeling and simultaneous simulation can be applied in heart surgery also, in kidney transplantation also in neurological transplantations like neuroprosthetic chip, then cochlear implant, rectal implant, all of these prosthetic devices also, as they are dealing with very, very subtle and the subtlest devices which may cause very, very untold miseries and injuries which cannot be easily made replaceable or retrievable by any other methodology of medicine, that we should be more meticulous and vigilant about these observations. For me, the same thing is now made in this area. So at first, the graphical designing and animation, what was first conferred only upon entertainment sources, only upon such predictive sources, now it has been a pivotal player in weather forecasting, in meteorology, in metallurgy, in casting and precision designing, in tools making, in engineering, in optical and aeronautical engineering, even in biomedical engineering it has come. When it was invented, it was not so much considered that it would have been totally Vyapaka or Vishnu, what we call all pervading and ubiquitous in all fields. It was not exposed before. So what I want to say is, we have to do two things. One, already emerging fields are there. Sit calmly in a particular platform, in a placid environment, and think about the existing platforms which are being simultaneously done by various universities. there is Hopkins University, there is Yale University, Colebrook University, and Wisconsin University Department of Multimedia. They are just forerunners and pioneers of various other new innovations. We can immediately go through those things and see how much we can do. So already attempted innovations, how long we can observe and how far we can participate, that is the one type of innovation. Second thing, independently we can sit and design where areas we can work out newly, creating name and fame and glory to the institution as well as to the national constitution, that we have to sit and work out. So two opportunities I've already told. One is foundations of the knowledge we have to sit and work out, and with the emerging trends we have to see what new areas we can open the doors for, what new windows we can open for the already existing open doors. And second thing is how it can be practically, experimentally or empirically translated so that we can get, create and establish job opportunities. For example, optical engineering is there and spintronics engineering is there. If these two engineering groups will come, it may come after 2012, it is what we are expecting. But if it comes, then more than two times of the multimedia professionals, I'm not talking about entertainment professionals, talking about designing professionals, talking about innovating layout designing professionals and mechanical drawing professionals and spintronic and mechatronic drawing professionals, if they are very much exclusively appointed for this purpose, it can take two times more than the persons who are in the multimedia industry now, spintronics and optical engineering. So these emerging fields that are there in modern science, that will open new opportunities for new students, and various other students will be impacted later. So as it is not a separate industry, multimedia industry is not a separate industry. It is a backbone, it is the optical tool, it is the vertebral column, and it is the invigilator, it is the facilitator for each and every emerging industry of the world, of the system of knowledge. So it will have evergreen and perennial systems. So what are the benefits for that? Number one is simplification. Second thing is encapsulation. Third thing is vivification. Fourth thing is alluration. These are all the benefits of multimedia. Simplification. If something is in the form of a big book, you need not read that. Seeing the book itself will create an inspiration that it is going to be a headache. It is known as initial impression. Whenever you see a big book or whenever you see a teacher, immediately, without listening to them or without going through them, closing your eyes, you can say that it is going to be a hectic schedule of punishment instead of being a knowledge nourishment. So that's what you will design. Second thing is, apart from simplification, if the same thing is presented in the form of an allured structure, a structure where you can be more inspired, a structure which you can imbibe more, that which is more attractive, immediately your mind goes there. See, it is the impression, it is the impression that makes you to feel the lightness and heaviness of things. So multimedia itself, naturally, it is multicolorful, it is multidimensional, it is very much entertaining. So that creates an impression that it is easy, that it is enjoyable. And this advent of multimedia, recent lecture given by some great scholar like Bell Kovikins at the Russia Petersburg University, he has quoted the advent of multimedia and advent of these e-learning and EduSat tools, they have made these students totally to forget or start hating the teachers as well as the other conventional tools like books and scripts. So this type of very wonderful types of presentation has made other things very grow obsolete. Then the second thing is encapsulation, that which requires different formulae and formation methodologies in conventional studies that can be encapsulated by means of a diagram. If it is in the form of a diagram, if it is in the form of a theoretic description, which is that depicted in the form of a model, depicted in the form of a structure, which is known as a multi-circular design or a tree, where there are innumerable patterns. What is a tree pattern? A tree pattern means that which is formulated as